my Nemo. Call the cards right, and you'll win the dough. On Card Sharks. And here's the host of Card Sharks, Jim Perry.
How are you? Thank you very much, and welcome to Card Sharks. Nice to have you here. Hi, thank you. You are very kind. Hope you had a pleasant weekend. Thank you for spending part of your valuable day with us. And we thank Walter Ducks of Jacksonville, Florida for that opening poem. And now, let's get to the cards. Janice and Markey, if you will, deal out two brand new decks of cards. We'll meet our players on Card Sharks. Hello there, Delangin Saisa, our champion.
Good
to be back. Good to see you again. And won't you again remind us about yourself, sir?
I'm Delangin Saisa. I'm from Colombo, Sri Lanka. I'm here in Los Angeles to go to graduate school at USC.
Did you bring the campus with you?
No. I hope to get my PhD next year. I have a lovely wife, Gauri, and we just found out that she's pregnant.
Wonderful. Congratulations. That's nice. And you've got a little head start on the baby there, putting a few dollars away. You've got $2,600 in cash as our champion, Delangin. Our challenger, Cindy Tedder. Hello, Cindy. Nice
Hi.
To see you again.
Good to see you.
And won't you remind us about yourself?
Certainly. I'm Cindy Tedder. I live in Valencia, California. I've been in California about 2 years. I'm an avid sports fan. I enjoy tennis, skiing, and jogging. And I also do some substitute teaching.
Good.
When I'm not out playing.
That's nice. Good to have you here with us. Good luck. You've cut the cards?
Yes.
Then we are all set to go. And the cards have been shuffled. The players cut them themselves. Delangin, the champion, plays the upper cards, the red deck. And Cindy, our challenger, plays the lower cards, the blue deck. We play the best two games out of three. And we'll start with a question to you, Delangin. Delangin, we asked 100 married women who own a dog. Now, be honest. Are there times when you treat your dog better than you treat your husband? How many women said sometimes they do treat their dog better than they treat their husband?
After being 4 years in this country, I find that the dogs are really treated good back home. But still, I think most of them like their husbands more than the dogs.
So how many treat the dogs better than the husband sometimes?
I think it would be pretty low, and I'd go with about 22.
22 sometimes treat their dog better than their husband, Cindy. Higher or lower?
Say that it's going to be a little bit higher. I don't have a dog, but I have a sister who has a dog, and she just spoils it rotten. So I'm going to say a little higher.
So you say higher. Well, if it is higher, you'll get the first crack at the cards. If not, it'll be the Delangin. And the actual number of married women who sometimes treat their dog better than they treat their husband is 32. You're right, Cindy. It is higher. I think the key word there was sometimes. Cindy, we'll start with a 10.
I'm going to change that.
Whenever you win the question, you have the right to change it to a jack.
All right.
A little better.
Lower. I'm going to go lower.
Lower than a jack. Yes,
all
a 2.
All right, all right. Higher.
Higher than a 2. It is a 9.
A freeze. Freeze right
and
there.
And we move over the freeze bar. Can't take those cards away from you. And that, of course, keeps Delangin away from his cards. Cindy, here's your first question. We asked 100 bachelors, have you ever suspected that a letter you wrote in an advice to the lovelorn column, have you ever suspected that a letter you read in an advice to the lovelorn column, you know, like Dear Abby or something, did you ever suspect that it was sent in by one of your girlfriends?
Oh, no.
How many bachelors said that they have suspected a letter that they read was sent in by one of their girlfriends?
I don't know how many bachelors are really reading the lovelorn column, so I'm going to say it's not going to be a very high number, around 25.
25. Said, that might have been written by a girlfriend.
I got to agree with her reasoning. I don't think bachelors are interested in this gossip. I'd go with maybe the number would be a little bit higher.
You think it'll be a little bit higher, though? Well, the actual number of bachelors who thought a letter in an advice to the lovelorn column was sent in by one of their girlfriends is 7, not higher. Cindy, very much lower. Cindy, we left off with a 9.
I'm going to change that 9.
Changing the 9 to a 6. A little better.
Oh, okay. I'm going to go higher.
Higher than a 6. Yes,
all
queen.
All right, all right. I'm going to go lower.
This is lower. You've got the first game of the match. For the win, it's an 8.
No.
And back to the base card of the 6, and you give Delangin a free chance to play a jack.
A lower.
Lower than the jack. Yes, a 4.
Higher.
Higher than a 4, a queen.
Lower.
Lower than a queen. A two. Higher. For the first game of the match. Yes, with four cards, DeLongin wins it. And game one to the champion. Wow, once he got a chance, he took advantage of it. We'll have game two right after this commercial break, so don't go away. Game one, won by the champion with $100, and Janice will set up with the same two decks of cards, and here come the next cards off the top of the decks. And we'll start game two with a question to you, DeLongin. DeLongin, we asked 100 single women, has a man ever tried to pick you up with such a corny line that you actually laughed in his face? How many women said they have?
I think that would be pretty common here. I had never tried it, and I never had no response, so there's no personal experience. But I would probably go around 62.
62 tried such a corny line that actually got laughed in the face. 100 single women.
I think that it's going to be a fairly high number. I know that I've had some pretty corny lines in my time, but I'm still going to say it's a little bit lower.
Lower.
Yes.
Well, the actual number of single women who laughed at a man because he used a corny line is 82. Yay! Not lower. It's very much higher, DeLongin. I mean, that really is ridiculous for somebody to try a corny line like that. Janice, what's a nice girl like you doing in a place like this? She's laughing. Look at that. Oh, DeLongin, you're starting with a queen.
I'll keep that and go lower.
Lower than a queen. It is a five.
I think that's okay. I'll try once more, a little bit higher.
Higher than a five. Yes, a six.
I think I'm going to freeze.
Freezing it, needing two cards, laughing at my lines, huh, Janice? Okay. Next question to you, Cindy. Cindy, we asked 100 United States Marines, U.S. Marines, do scary movies give you nightmares? How many Marines said, yes, they do?
I don't know any Marines, but I know if I watch a scary movie, I don't think about it that night. So I'm going to say the number's fairly low, around 20.
20 U.S. Marines get a nightmare from scary movies.
Marines are the tough guys. And I don't think a movie's going to scare them, no. It's lower than that.
Lower than that. The actual number of Marines who said scary movies give them nightmares is 6. Very much lower, DeLongin. Yes.
I change the card, please.
You want to change that 6?
I change it, please.
Changing the 6 to a 5.
Oh, a little bit better. Higher.
Higher than a 5. Yes, an 8.
I'm going to freeze.
And DeLongin needs one card for another crack at the big money with the money cards. DeLongin. We asked 100 women, have you ever saved the gift wrap from one present and used it on another one? How many women said they have?
I know a lot of women who do it, and I think it's going to be a very, very high number. My wife does it.
Oh, yes?
Yes. I'll go with about 77.
77. You got suspicious when your wife sent you a birthday present with baby wrappings, had the DeLongin? So you said 77 women. You ever saved the gift wrap from one present, used it for another, Cindy? What do you think?
I'm going to say that I know I've done it many a time, so I'm going to say it's still going to be a little bit higher.
Higher than that?
Yes.
We both think it's fairly common. Let's find out. The actual number of women who have saved the gift wrap from one present and used it for another one is 71. Not higher, DeLongin.
I change the card, please.
Didn't even wait for me to get over here to change that 8 to a 4.
That's a good card. I'll go higher.
Higher for the championship. Yes! Yay! DeLongin wins it. And he just methodically went along there. Cindy, thank you for joining us.
Very okay,
fun.
I enjoyed it. I certainly
Look,
did.
We had some nice party this
thank
way.
You.
Thanks for coming. Cindy Tedder. Thank you, Cindy. Come on, DeLongin. Well, with the $200 in that game, DeLongin, you're now up to $2,800 and going for the big dollars right after this commercial break. Way to go. Back with our champion, DeLongin Sisa. Are you ready?
Yes.
Let's open the board and get to the money cards. Come on, DeLongin. Here we go. And the money cards have been shuffled and cut. Janice will start dealing them out, as we'll give you $200 on the bottom line and these three cards. When you move up to the second level, we'll add another $200 and three more cards. Remember, your minimum bets are $50. Till you get to the top card, the big bet, and there you must risk at least half the money. A lot of money there. We're with you. Here's $200, DeLongin. Remember, you can change your base card on each of the three levels if you need to, and you're starting with a 5. Do you want it?
I think I'll keep it and bet $100 higher.
Playing the five, $100 higher. No, three.
That's okay, I like that. I'll bet $100 higher.
$100 higher than the three. Yes, now we're moving back to 200 with a jack.
I'll bet another $100 lower.
$100 lower than a jack. It is a 10. Good. 300, up goes to 10. We give you the other $200, you've
got
500.
I'm going to
pay the 10. And again, as you move up, you can change it. So he gets a 4.
Good, I like that.
Card.
I go $400 higher.
$400. That this is higher than a 4. And it
That's
is very
good.
Much a king.
I go $800 lower.
$800 lower than a king. Yes,
I
a 2. Great card.
I go everything higher.
Risking $1,700 higher than a 2. Yes, with a 4. $3,400 and a pretty good card. Big decision. You going to play it?
That's a good card, and there are a lot of low cards here. I'm going to bet $3,000 higher.
Oh, a big bet. $3,000 higher than a 4.
Yeah!
$400 with the ace. Ah, that'll help pay for the new baby. Good job. Way to go.
Thank you.
Good play.
Thank you.
And you played it very well, too.
Thank you.
And DeLongin, that gets you up to $9,200.
That's really great.
And a new challenger coming out right after this. That's a good job. Good job. And that ace came up just a... We're back with our champion. DeLongin, you played those cards super.
Thank you.
It's really a pleasure to see somebody do it that way. You held back when you had to and bet when you had the good cards.
I consider myself a cautious gambler.
A cautious gambler. Well, you're well over $9,000 now. Good job.
Okay.
DeLongin will deal out two brand new decks of cards and meet a new challenger on Card Sharks. Edith Lurie. Hello, Edith. Welcome. Nice to have you here. We're delighted to meet you.
Glad to be here.
Could you tell us about yourself, ma'am?
Yes. My name is Edith Lurie, and I live in Santa Barbara, formerly from Seattle. And I have 7 grandchildren. I have a great-grandson.
Congratulations.
And I just found out today. Today is my birthday, too. And I just found
out. Happy birthday.
Thank you. And I just found out that I'm going to have another great-grandson this summer.
Oh.
You know, I was afraid for a moment you were going to tell me I'm going to have a great-great-grandson. Nice to have you here with us, Edith. Did you
Thank
cut the cards?
You. Yes.
Then we are all set to go, and
okay.
You'll play the lower cards, the blue cards. DeLongin, the upper cards, the red, and we'll start with a question to you, DeLongin. DeLongin, we asked 100 bachelors, have you ever gone home after a date and actually taken a cold shower? How many bachelors said they have?
Well, I was a bachelor, and no, I never did it personally.
Yeah, we all didn't start off married, I figure that.
Yeah, and I don't think really... too many people would have done that. I'd go with about 27.
27. We always hear that. DeLongin says 27 bachelors actually took a cold shower.
Did he say 27?
27.
Well, I have 3 sons, and I can't remember them ever coming home after a date and taking a cold shower. So I think I'll say a little lower.
I wonder what the reason for that was, Edith. Never mind, you said lower. The actual number of bachelors who've taken a cold shower after a date is 19. You're right, Edith, it's lower. Well, you can get kind of dirty out there. Edith, you're starting with an 8.
I'd like to change the 8,
you
please.
You can indeed, ma'am. Changing the 8 to our big 8.
Oh, higher. No, lower.
You see, there aren't many higher than that.
No. I mean, that's good and high.
Lower than an 8, she says, and yes, a 3.
Now higher.
Now higher than a 3. It is a 6.
I'll freeze.
Freezing it. Over goes the freeze bar, and Edith is off and running with a 2-card lead. Edith. Now, we found, you were talking about your family. Listen to this. We found 100 women who have 10 or more children.
Yeah.
And we asked them, since you woke up this morning, have you had to wait for someone in your family to get out of the bathroom before you could get in?
Oh,
how many
I'm
said
sure
they had?
That they would have to. With 10 or more children, they'd certainly have to wait. I would say About 78.
78? Had to wait to get into the bathroom, Delongin.
I think that's a very good answer. And having 10 children and probably not working, she has to wait till all the children get to school or work. So, but I think the number is going to be a little bit lower.
Just a little lower.
A little bit lower.
The actual number of women with 10 or more children who had to wait to get in the bathroom is 39. Very much lower, Delongin. Yes. You know, I figured out the reason. There were a whole bunch of people in there taking a cold shower. Delongin, you're starting with a 6.
I think I'll change that, please.
Changing the 6 to a
That's
jack.
That's a bit better. Lower.
Lower than a jack. Yes, a 7.
I'm going to freeze.
And Delongin is trailing by one card as we go to question 3. Delongin, we found 100 teenage girls with steady boyfriends, and we asked them, did you ask your parents' permission to go steady? How many teenage girls said yes, they did ask for permission?
No, not in this day and age, no. It's going to be very, very low. Probably go with about 10.
10 teenage girls with steady boyfriends.
I don't think very many of them would ask their parents, but I'm going to say a little higher than 10.
A little more than that.
Yeah.
The actual number of teenage girls who asked their parents' permission to go steady is 4. Not higher, Delongin. 4. Do you want that 7?
I'm going to change the card, please.
Changing the 7 to a
That's
king.
Much better. Lower.
Lower than a king. A 2.
That's fantastic. Higher. Higher.
Higher than a 2. A jack.
Jack. I think I'm going to freeze.
You'll freeze.
Yeah.
Needing one card to eat this 2. And, well, Delongin may have been figuring that this is sudden death, and he didn't want to take a chance. Edith, someone must win with this play of the cards. Listen carefully, Edith. We asked 100 Mississippi State Troopers, are you nervous when you go to the dentist? How many Mississippi State Troopers admitted they are?
Well, I don't think many people like to go to the dentist, but a Mississippi State Trooper... That's a different story again. I would say about 40.
40 Mississippi State Troopers nervous when they go to the dentist.
Everybody's nervous to go to the dentist. They don't like what you do inside your mouth. But being troopers, I'd say it's going to be a little bit lower.
Lower.
A little bit lower.
The actual number of Mississippi State Troopers who are nervous when they go to the dentist is 49. Not lower, Edith. Edith, you have a 6. You need 2 cards.
I'd like to change it, please.
And, well, listen carefully. It's sudden death, Edith. Oh. You may not want to play it. It's your decision. But Delongin has a jack and needs 1 card. Do you want to play it yourself or force him to play it?
I think I'll play it. I'll take a chance.
Do you want to play that 6 or change it now?
I want to change
it. Yes, ma'am. We want to give you all the options. You're going to change the 6 to a queen.
Then I'll try it lower.
Lower than a queen. Remember, if you're wrong, Delongin wins the game in sudden death. That's a 3.
I'll try it higher.
For the first game in the match, higher, yes. And Edith wins it in sudden death. And Edith, you've got game 1 and $100. Janice will set up for game 2, if you will. And if you can remember what cards have been played, it might help you, because here come the next cards off the top of the deck. Delongin, as we start game 2, the question goes to you. We asked 100 people, have you ever tried to return a Christmas gift to a store and been told, I'm sorry, we haven't stocked that item in years? How many people said that's happened to them?
I think a lot of people would have tried to return the Christmas presents, but I'm not sure whether if they knew which store the person got the present from, they're going to get such an answer. So I'm going to go with a lower number, about 18.
18 people have tried to return a Christmas gift, and the store said, sorry, haven't stocked it.
You know, I'm ashamed to admit, I just did that last week. And the store told me, we haven't stocked that number in a few years, but we did stock it in the past, and they did take it back for me.
So
I'm going to say a little higher.
Higher. Well, the actual number of people who've returned a gift and been told we haven't stocked that item in years is 16. Not higher, Delongin. Almost right on the button. And Delongin, you start with a 3.
I love the card. Yeah, higher, please.
Higher than a 3. Yes, a 10.
10. I haven't seen too many low cards. I'm going to go lower.
He's going to risk it lower than a 10. Yes,
no, no, I'm going to freeze.
Now he freezes, needing 2 cards. Edith has yet to turn over a card in this game, and we've got to turn things over to the commercial people. We'll be right back right after this. That's all the time we have for today. Have a good day. See you tomorrow on Card Sharks. Bye-bye.
One of our polling groups will receive a big 19-cubic foot upright freezer. Features energy-efficient trim wall insulation, lighted interior, shelves for easy rotation and access to foods. Built-in lock and safety signal light furnished by Kelvinator. And some of our contestants will receive Plumbee's Budget Keeper. It's pocket-sized, practical, and makes keeping your budget easy. We organize Phyllis Diller. We can organize you. And Bedsack, new idea in bed covering, provides luxury upholstery for your old mattresses and box springs and protection for new. Furnished by Bedsack. And Lacrosse, quality manicure accessories. A standard of quality for nail files, tweezers, nail clips, emery boards, cuticle and nail scissors and nippers, Lacrosse. And a gift pack including Sous Vie Spun Cream Honey, the soft spreadable honey in the reusable plastic table server. Sous Vie Spun Cream Honey, the delicious pure honey spread. This is Gene Woods speaking for Card Sharks, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.